Occasionally, you run into problems with the OST file getting corrupt or taking up too much disk space. Here's how you can resolve those issues. The OST file is used to store offline data so that when you travel, you can work on emails and then connect back to your network and send and receive those at a later time. That information is stored in an OST file located on your C drive. You can see where that's located by going into File, Account Settings, under Account Settings, and click on Data Files. In the list, you'll see the location of the OST file. If you go into Settings, Advanced, this is the Outlook data file settings. First thing to try is to do the compact now to shrink down the disk space used. But if the file is corrupt or if it doesn't work properly because of an error, then you may need to delete the OST file completely from your C drive. To do that, let's go back and click on the Open File location. You can see here that the OST file is fairly large. My example, it's 4.5 gig, which is very big. Now, the only way you can delete the file is if you exit out of Outlook and any other Office applications that would keep this file locked. So I'm going to leave the file location open, click Close, and close Outlook. And now we can delete the OST file, then open Outlook once again. You'll notice that it's preparing Outlook for the first use, because it's rebuilding this OST file and the file size is much smaller. And that's how you delete the OST file if it becomes corrupt or too large. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.